So the main differences between the ordinary and the velocipede, the bone shaker, which I was riding before, is the gear ratio, the most important, memorable thing to know about the wheel being much bigger, rubber tyres instead of steel, you've got metal spokes instead of great big wooden spokes, so they can take a lot more of an impact, because they're built, when, just as they are modern bikes, they're cross, so they have a pressure holding them there. Also, you have the back wheel being small, so it's lighter. This bike is generally lighter than the bone shaker, and also it is a lot more comfortable to ride. And personally, I find it a lot easier to ride, even though I'm all the way up there. Despite the fact this bike being renowned for being dangerous and uncomfortable, as I said before, riding it's just so smooth and quiet, and it's such a lovely bike to ride. And I've been 20 miles on it, and after that I came back and I could have gone 20 more. It's just lovely, and despite the fact of the car engine that my cameraman's sitting in, this bike is completely silent. I just roll along, and when I get to a hill, you sort of got to challenge yourself to get up it, and I can get quick on it as well. I've overtaken people wearing Lycra on the most modern expensive bikes, which is quite funny. They weren't going at their top speed, obviously, but you can go pretty quick. Yeah. As I said before, I always get questions asked to me about this bike, and the question I get asked the most is, how did you get on and off it? Because this bike is so high off the ground and you can't touch the ground when you're up there, obviously if it's not moving you're going to go off sideways. So it has to be moving, and this is what this little step here is for. You grab both handlebars and you step along with one foot on there, and you hop along to your rolling, and then you jump up and catch the pedals in your feet and hopefully keep your balance. So, foot on the step, hop along, and push yourself up, jump on the saddle, catch the pedals, and that's all you need to know. To get off, you can't get off sideways, so you have to get off the way you came on, like that. This bike doesn't exactly have brakes, as it has a brake. What I do is this handle here, I pull in, and all it does is press down this onto the tyre. Now this is the bicycle that made the penny farthing history. This is the Kangaroo, and the main difference between this, it may look like a little penny farthing for a child or something, but it's not. It has one gear cog, one gear ratio, which means the big wheel is no longer necessary.
Yes, this was the first attempt at making a bicycle that was actually safe, and also a bicycle that was really fast.
Yes.
Because
practical.
If you want a high gear, if you're racing, you need a really big wheel, but there's a limit, because depending on the length of your legs, you can only ride a wheel that is a certain height.
Because the ordinary is custom made.
Exactly, yeah. They were fitted to your inside leg, which is straight enough, I want to be.
Yes.
The other problem is that you're so high up, which means that if you want to get off or if you fall off, it's a very long way down. This combines both problems into a very elegant solution with gearing up the front wheel, which means you can gear it up really high to go incredibly fast, and you're also much nearer the ground, although I have to say one of the commentators at the time, Lacey Hillier, did say that the only thing that made this a safety bicycle was that it was less far to fall. Not that you were less likely to fall, because just like the high wheel bicycle, if you put on the brake firmly, straight down.
As I explained earlier,
It is actually much safer and easier to ride.
Yeah.
And the thing that sealed the success of this bicycle was the 100 mile race in 1884, and one virtually identical to this. This is an 1884, one of the earliest pattern, was raced, and it absolutely smashed the record, possibly because it had a very good cyclist on it. The other reason is, I think because it's lower, probably the cyclist can put more effort into it, and there isn't the fear and the falling factor and all the rest. Once it had won the 100 miles race, then effectively, the market took over. Yes. These sold like hot cakes. These were like skateboards when they first came out.
Yeah.
Everybody had to have one. And then that lasted for about 2.5 years. And then Mr. Starley invented the Rover bicycle, which was like our modern bicycle, with a chain on the rear wheel and equal wheels, which is much harder to go over the front of.
Yes.
And they got another racing cyclist to go out on that, and they broke the record of this bicycle on 100 miles.
What a shame.
That sealed its fate.
Yes.
But, I have to say, I find this actually better and more comfortable to ride than the modern type bicycle.
Yes.
It's absolutely wonderful.
From looking at it, compared with the ordinary, where ever so, even though it can still go over the top, this wheel does seem is larger than the back wheel on the
Yes.
And it would be slightly more safe than going over the top. Then
you're also sitting further back, so you
Yes, weight, yes. So, yeah, shall we give it a ride?
I think that's a good idea.
This is much, much more nice to ride. You feel a lot safer.
Less far to fall.
Over the last 2 centuries, so much has changed in the world. Things like bicycles and cars and buildings, they've become so practical and modern, I think they've completely lost their charm. And I think it's a shame that you don't see bikes like this around today. But if there were lots of bikes like this around today, they would be quite so unusual.